أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون رضا بقضائه وتسليما لأمره. We have reached the night which is called Shami Ghariba. As you heard in the Marsiya, that this is the most difficult time for Ahli Haram, as there's no one left to guard them, to protect them. And you imagine these women who never stepped out of their houses for anything unnecessary. And up until this point, this morning, they were still in the protection of the tents, and their hijab were intact. But now, after Imam Hussein has been martyred, now their hijab are no longer protected. The ladies who never stepped out as a person who lived next to Imam Ali all his life in Medina. He said, I lived next to Ali, but I have never heard the voice of Zainab. Just imagine Zainab in this bayaban, in this desert, in this jungle, amongst na-mihram and those who are ashqiya and the enemies. Can you add more difficulty to Zainab? And on top of that, the responsibility to take care of the children and the little ones and rest of the women and be a protector of them. Ajrukum Allah. Yes, the news of the martyrdom of Hussein reached all over. Umm Salma sees in a dream Rasulullah is sitting with his amama down and with khak and sand in his head. Umm Salma wakes up from this dream. She immediately looks at the khak that Rasulullah had left with her. She sees that khak has turned into blood. So she realizes that Hussein is no longer alive. That is why when Imam Hussein was martyred, the sound was raised. There was this sound that was raised that people could hear. It was so dark, it became during the daytime, that it became so dark. And there were winds that were blowing all around. And it says it was blood was raining from the sky. On that day, you picked up any stone and you would see blood coming out of beneath that stone. Every single creation of Allah was weeping blood for Hussein. Yes, Allah qad qutila al-Hussein, Allah qad dhubiha al-Hussein fi Karbala, bi Karbala, that indeed Hussein has been martyred in Karbala, and Hussein has been slaughtered in Karbala. And if it was not enough that they had killed Imam Hussein and his companions, they said, we have to sever the heads of all of the shuhada. They line up people and they start severing the heads because they have to send the heads to Kufa, to their Amir right away. And in the process, when they were severing the heads, one person says, I did not get a head, because if you present a head to Amir, you will get a reward. And they said, we're missing one head. Remember the 6-month-old Imam had already buried in the ground out of the fear that they do not desecrate Ali Azhar. They started with the spears going around in the land of Karbala, piercing the spear into the ground, and eventually one riwayat mentions that the body of Ali Asghar was also discovered, and they severed the head of Ali Asghar and it was presented sitting next to the head of Imam Hussein. Ajrukum Allah, may Allah give you no grief. This is where Pisar-e-Saad he says, who amongst you are going to go ahead and run and stampede over the bodies of shuhada? 10 men prepared to do that. But before they did that, there were individuals who went to the body of Hussein. Someone took the shirt of Hussein off. It is mentioned in riwayat that man developed a skin disease and he died of that. Another man took the amama of Imam Hussein. It is mentioned that this man went insane after doing that. Another man wanted to take the ring from the fingers of Hussein. He said it was stuck so badly that I could not remove it. Eventually, I had to chop off the hand so that I could gain this ring from Hussein. This is how they treated the body of Sayyid al-Shuhada. Ajrukum al-Allah. May Allah give you no grief. But what came after this was more devastating. They say, now go ahead and attack the tents and take whatever mal ghanimat you can attain. This is where they started burning the tents. One of the daughters of Imam Hussein says, Ashqiya came to me. He came, the Shaqi, he wanted to snatch my earrings. He said, while he was snatching, he was also crying. I said, why do you cry? He said, because I'm snatching the earring of the daughter of Rasulullah. He said, then why are you doing it? He said, if I don't do it, someone else will do it. Ajrukum Allah. Another daughter of Hussein says that when I saw the ladies, their chadars were being snatched, I was scared lest they look towards me. Eventually, this man looked toward me. He came running after me. He hit me behind my back that I fell unconscious. After a while, when I woke up, my aunt Umm Kulsoom was sitting next to me. She said, Beta, get up, we have to leave because the tents are burning. I said, oh aunt, give me some chadar so I can cover my head. My aunt responded, look at your aunt's head. Even she does not have any covering on her head. Ajrukum al-Allah, may Allah give you no grief or sorrow except the grief of Ahlul Bayt. This is Sham-e-Ghariba, the first night after Imam Hussein has been slain. Before leaving, Imam Hussein gave this wasiyat to Zainab. La tansini fi salatil layl. O Zainab, do not forget me in your salatul layl. Imam has so much confidence that after all the troubles, even those difficult times, Zainab would not be heedless of Salatul Layl. I would say, Mawla, what else did you tell Zainab? He said, make sure that you take care of my Sakina. Make sure that you take care of my Sakina. Imam gave the wasiyat. A special wasiyat to Sakina. As the tents were burning, Janab Zainab is moving from one tent to another. Women are moving from one tent to another. As they are moving from one tent to another, Hamid says that I saw this lady. She would go in and out of a tent. That was Zainab, who went and asked Imam Sajjad, oh Beta Sajjad, should we burn inside the tents or should we save our lives? Imam Sajjad, whose bed was also snatched from beneath him, he said, you are knowledgeable. You know that we have to save our lives. Get out of the tents and save your lives, even though you do not have any covering on your head. And I saw him, he says, this lady would go inside this burning tent. Then she would come out. She would repeat this process. I asked her, do you have something valuable in that tent? She said, they took all the mal ghanimat. My nephew is lying sick in this tent. And then one riwayah says, Janab Zainab, carrying Imam Sajjad on her shoulder, comes out of this tent in this fashion. Ajrukum Allah, may Allah give you no grief, no sorrow, except the grief and sorrow of Ahlul Bayt. Sham ghariba, how difficult it is. You just heard in the Masai Marsiya as well that Imam Hussein gave this wasiyat to take care of the kids. As soon as the dust settled, when all the tents were burnt, there were kids running all over the place. They said the kids were lost, as if you have opened up a tasbih and the beads of tasbih are spread out. Children were all around. One person says that I ran into a four-year-old child. His name was Bakr. That's your Imam Muhammad Baqir. He said he was headed towards Najaf. Oh, beta, oh, my son, where are you going? He said, I'm going towards Najaf. He said, how are you going to go there? Why do you want to go? He said, I want to go call upon my grandfather, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Come and take a look. What has happened in Karbala? Ajrukum Allah. May Allah give you no grief. Zainab starts counting the children. One by one, she's gathering all the kids. When all the kids were gathered, she realizes the individual for which Imam had given special instructions, Sakina, is missing. Janab Zainab gets up. Imagine the darkness of that land. Imagine that desert, that jungle where there's no light. Janab Zainab, how would she find Sakina in that desert where their bodies lying all over? She goes around. She calls, oh Sakina, oh Sakina, respond, where are you? You are the wasiyat of your father. As she was going around, she says she ran into a body where she saw little Sakina was hugging and sleeping. She wakes up Sakina, picks her up. She said, oh Sakina, what are you doing over here? Sakina responded, oh Bobi Amma, when this was happening, when the dust settled, when the tents were burning, we were running in all different directions. I was calling upon my Baba. Baba, Janab Zainab said, you recognize a body either by their face or by some signs of their clothes. This body has neither face. It does not have a head. It does not have any clothes. How did you recognize this is the body of your father? She said, I was calling Baba. Meri madad ko aaiye Baba. Baba, come for my help. And as I was calling, I saw two hands raised. I immediately fell on that, and this was the body. Ajrukum Allah, may Allah give you no grief, no sorrow, except the grief of Ahlul Bayt. Bas ye aakhri manzar, iske baad se Zainab, Janab Sakina ko leke aati hain, ikhatta kiya, barabar mein bachchon ko bithaya, sare bachche jab baith gaye, phir sare saad ne pani bheja, riwayat ke mutabik pani laya gaya, Janab Zainab, khawateen pani se inkaar karti, lekin jab bachchon ki प्यास देखी, सकीना को करीब बुलाया, बेटा सकीना, पानी पी लो, कहा पुपी अम्मा, पहले आप पीजे, कहा नहीं, पहले बच्चे पीते हैं, बस ये सुनना था, कूजा हाथ में लिया, मक्तल का रुख किया, अरे सकीना, किधर जाती हो, अरे आपने ही तो कहा था, पहले बच्चे पीते हैं, मेरा भैया अली असगर, इस दुनिया से रुखसत हो गया.
Oh.